from Panama. My name is Dariana Balbuena. I am from the Dominican Republic.
And my name is Esteban Murillo, and I'm from Costa Rica. We have two children, Etienne, who is 6 years old, and Dana, our little baby girl, who is just 1 year old.
Etienne was born in Costa Rica and Dana in Panama, so basically we are from three different countries. We have been global missionaries for 3 years now. Since then, I have been serving as the National Compassionate Ministries Coordinator for our Mesoamerica region.
And I do coordinate communications as well for the entire region. Actually, we live in Panama, close to our regional office from where we serve. 3 years ago, getting ready to leave Costa Rica, we were selling our belongings, our car, and it was easy, but not our house. Since we're still paying it to the bank, we really needed to sell it or at least give it for rent. But nothing happened, even though we came to the mission field.
For 10 months, we were paying our house out of our savings, and one night, my husband came to say that we wouldn't be able to make it to the next month, that we were about to lose our house. We knew for sure that turning back was easier, but not what God wanted for us to do. Since we said yes to his calling, he wanted to remind us that this was his will. Yes, it's still his will. We were praying for a miracle since before we left our country, and now the only thing I was able to tell my husband was, don't worry, let's pray, for the Lord will do this. And hey, he did. Someone came and started to rent our house in the very perfect moment. And since then, our house has been rented.
When he calls, he always supports, and he will never leave you alone. So we have seen that have encouraged us.
Now we want to share with you a little bit about our call to mission. Our stories are very long, but we will make it very short for you to at least to get an idea of this. When I was 12 years old, I started to serve at my local church as a teacher for younger kids. I was able also to get involved at NCM, working outside in the community, and I felt in love with serving, in the needs that I was able to see around. And I have this feeling that the Lord was calling me to do something different, to maybe dedicate my whole life to this. So I came one night to my father. He was a pastor. He is still a pastor in one of our Nazarene churches in the Dominican Republic. So I came to him and I said that I think that the Lord is calling me to be a missionary. Maybe he was not that happy at the very beginning, understanding the meaning, you know, of ministry and all of that, because he was there already. But as I was growing and getting more and more involved in ministry, in my local church, in my district, in my country, in my field, in my region, that was the Caribbean region before, I, you know, always had this understanding, and that was the only way I was able to find the joy of the Lord when I was out there serving others, when I was able to dedicate my days, my time to serve others. So that was when, and my response was immediately, you know, I was kind of clear since that very moment, even when I was a child. And the Lord is still confirming, and always, anytime I have a doubt, he is still confirming, yes, this is where I want you to be.
The first time that I understood that God was calling me, I need to be honest with you. I said, no way. No, I don't want to do it. I feel like in my life I was serving him in my local church, as a youth pastor with my wife, serving in NYI, serving in SDMI, serving with the worship team. And I was like, I don't need to do anymore. I'm okay. I'm doing what he called me to do. But, you know, when God calls, he will continue calling. Hey, Lord, I'm giving up to you. I'm giving up to your call. It wasn't easy. You know, I think maybe three and a half years, I said to the Lord, no, look at my house, look at my family. look at my job, look at my studies. I was saying no all the time, but you know, God says, okay, I want you. At the end, I said, okay, you want me? You want us as a family to serve together? Okay, so I'm gonna say yes. But it wasn't easy. But let me tell you something. Probably is one of my best decisions ever. So if God is calling you, please, don't be like me. Say yes at first time. But, you know, say yes. Take your time, but say yes.
Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in Him, and He will do this. Psalm 37, 5.
Trinidad and Tobago District, thank you for being in our links. We love you and we pray for you.
And thank you for supporting the mission. Thank you for support with the web. And from the bottom of our hearts, God bless you very much.
God bless you. Hope to see you very soon in person. Bye.